Yeah, that was dumb. So we're trying to get we're trying to funnel the experience into Terra. As best we can. So how that works is you basically put your command in so that their ATB gauge is recharging, the person that you want to keep in the battle, and then have the other two characters have their gauge full and then try to run away. Well, the character gaining the ATB gauge won't run away, the other two might. A little slow there, but I might still be able to get it. I'm gonna go for it. Should have had that over and done with in the first round there, but I don't know. Maybe I missed something. I've never heard of anyone recovering this fast. Like, this happens often in your parts. Your job is removing these crowns from people, or what? I can't believe I only encountered one battle in this whole thing. Treasure hunter. Thank you. It's funny, they look like Lone Wolf, the pickpocket. Kind of, don't they? So we just go after the marshal here because he hits hard and he can affect our speed. Typically I'll steal until successful and then just fight. Where's his sprint shoes? He's obviously got them stashed somewhere. I had one more battle in that cave, I would have leveled up before Locke. Or before acquiring Locke. That sucks. That's why I stood around and fought that extra battle. Before the Esper encounter. Just because I was hoping. Hoping that I could, you know, get that level up first. But then I only fought one battle the whole time in that cave. I kind of feel like I got ripped off a little bit. Thank you. hell am I doing? What a weasel. Thank you. I'll do it. How do they know? How do they know human? How do they know that no human can be born with magical powers? I think they're making assumptions. What am I doing? Not paying attention, that's what we're doing. Well, that's a potentially fortuitous turn of events. Probably we're not going to learn anything on the Veld, but there's the possibility that that would be something that came up and that would be cool. Oh, crap. Oh, really? Seriously? Kind of lucky we didn't get poisoned there. Oh, that's too bad. Thank you. Oh, really? The Genji Glove. Whoops. No. Well, hopefully that doesn't happen. Oh, come on, dude. Thank you. interceptor. I'm a pretty big fan of Interceptor. He tells them to attack and they go slam themselves up against the stone walls. Character that I don't know. There was promise and potential. So much promise and potential. Yeah, it's too bad that Leo couldn't have been part of the party. You know, like at the end, on the other side of the world. It's just too bad that they didn't have to, like, I don't know. He could have been imprisoned or something. History bub. You're a goner. the heck am I doing? Oh, man. Whatever. Of course. Interceptor would be nice right now. What a lowdown. Yeah, this really was probably the single worst thing that Kefka did. It's just, it really didn't, it was just mean-spirited. Understand, in, you know, military situations, sometimes difficult decisions need to be made, but I don't think poisoning... Oh, what am I doing? I don't think poisoning, I mean, I guess we don't know what Dom has been up to, you know? We don't really know. We just know that Kefka was up in Figaro. And things didn't go to his liking, and now he comes down to Doma. And, you know, he's becoming more advanced. He used fire to try and burn Figaro. It didn't work. So he's kind of salty about that, no doubt. And so now he's like, well, they won't make an ass out of me. Again, I'll just poison them all.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
You know what? I think I've figured it out, and I'm gonna have to figure out how to disable this thing, or if maybe it's just a Microsoft deal. I don't know. Maybe I'm gonna have to. So. Every now and again, my controller just blinks off and back on again. Now, it doesn't disconnect from the PC, obviously, because you're still listening to me. But it disconnects from the hardware momentarily, and then I have to reconnect it, so it's like a pain in my ass. I saw this little widget in the bottom right-hand corner of the whatever that bar is that runs in the bottom of your screen, right? Sometime back, Microsoft installed this thing. It's like a little widget that just tells you what the temperature is, and if you hover over it or click on it, it will like bring up shit that nobody wants to look at, no doubt. But I think, because when I went over there, it looked like it was maybe like just a, like updating or something, the temperature or whatever, which I don't mind that, you know, that's, I don't mind having the temperature being told to me. I mean, it's not like it's a huge deal. But if for some reason that causes a problem with anything, then, you know, let's get rid of that shit. And I had looked into trying to get rid of it before, but I was not able to isolate anything. But I feel like it has something to do with Microsoft Edge, which I don't hardly ever use. I'm gonna have it on my computer, but I don't even know if you can remove it from your computer. Oh yeah, dir. What am I doing? I'm just totally like on autopilot, not even thinking. For some reason, I was thinking I was in a world of ruin. Going to talk to Edgar. I don't know how my mind wandered to that place. But I literally, that's where my mind was telling me to go. And then when I saw the merchant standing there, I was like, what the hell? And I was like, oh yeah, duh. You know, I remember when I first played this, I could not solve this riddle for anything for the longest time. Because the only hint you have is the rich man's house, right? So you're just thinking, well, it must be the rich man's house. He wants his cider, or the bar, which isn't the case. I forget. Failure. It's funny, he used to work for the richest man in town, and his house is like the second nicest house in town. Oh, wrong button. Oops. I don't know why that is a thing there. Just leaning into her. And why is she here? Of all the places, like, why is she? Why is she in South Figaro? I can go days without sleep. If by days you mean less than a minute. That's another thing that is, they give you two options here in this room that don't really do anything for you. I've often wondered if it's worth even getting these pieces of gear here. Did I skip the earrings in the Phantom Train? I feel like I did. I mean, it wouldn't be the end of the world, but still. I feel like I did not. Should have tried to steal first. Thank you.
Thank you.
Weird. Or is it not? A strange color. The sky and the light outside are a strange color. Alright, let's I guess make a save. And I guess everybody should be he's good, she's good. No. Come on. So normally I use the Primordite Rage here, but we don't have it. So we're going to try and use Runic. We didn't want to do that. Ooh, ow. Let's go ahead and do this then, just because we can't have that. That's not gonna do it. Boy, this is an expensive fiasco here. Thank you. Dude, seriously, you're still up? That's three attacks. Again, that's expensive. He's gotta be done here. I did not have my earrings. I don't believe. It's like orange outside. It's weird. That's not the right color for outside. It's like there's some kind of a haze in the air covering up the sun and filtering it to a different color. It's kind of, I can't say I've never seen anything like it before, but it's definitely, different. All right, thank you for your time, and I appreciate every single one of you in every way that you show me support, and I appreciate that. I just want to say thank you, and I will be back here before too long. I'm going to take a little break, and I'll come back.